Media playback is unsupported on your device. Media caption: Why Hurricane Maria hit Puerto Rico so hard. U.S. President Donald Trump has said he will travel next week to Puerto Rico amid a growing crisis in the wake of destruction caused by Hurricane Maria. "That island was hit as hard as you can hit," he said at the White House. Puerto Rico's governor has appealed for federal help, warning the island is on the brink of a humanitarian crisis. The Trump administration is facing criticism over its response to the situation on the U.S. island territory, which the storm has left without power. Meanwhile, 44% of the 3.5 million residents living on the island are still without clean drinking water 6 days after the storm barreled through, the Defense Department said on Tuesday. Mr. Trump said the U.S. was sending food, water and supplies on an hourly basis. Image copyright Getty Images. Image caption: Nearly half of the U.S. territory lack clean drinking water after the passage of Hurricane Maria. U.S. officials say Puerto Rico is very important to me, he added. The people are fantastic. I grew up in New York, so I know many Puerto Rican people. Mr. Trump said next Tuesday, which will be nearly a fortnight after the storm struck, was the earliest I can go without disrupting relief efforts. He may also visit the U.S. Virgin Islands, which was hit by both Hurricane Maria and Irma, he added. The White House also on Tuesday announced Mr. Trump had increased federal funding and assistance for debris removal and emergency protective measures in Puerto Rico in the aftermath of the storm. Media playback is unsupported on your device. Media caption: Trump never seen anything like Puerto Rico. More than 10,000 U.S. Federal Emergency Management Agency FEMA staff are on the ground in Puerto Rico and the U.S. Virgin Islands to assist with relief efforts, according to the agency. Addressing criticism, the president said his administration was doing a really good job and that the governor of Puerto Rico, Ricardo Rossello, was so grateful. He said rescue efforts were complicated because Puerto Rico was offshore. It's a big ocean, it's a very big ocean. And we're doing a really good job, he said. This is a thing called the Atlantic Ocean, this is tough stuff, he added. The president's announcement came after the mayor of San Juan, Puerto Rico, asked the U.S. to put people above debt. Mayor Carmen Yulín's comments to CNN followed tweets by President Trump saying the island's $72 billion, £53 billion debt needed to be addressed amid its appeal for relief aid. When someone is in a life or death situation, the mayor said, there is a human, moral imperative to deal with that situation before dealing with anything else. She also said two patients on life support died on Monday because a hospital ran out of diesel, CBS News reports. The island's government asked a judge on Monday to defer key deadlines in its bankruptcy case as it grapples with Maria's devastation. Meanwhile, Puerto Rico Governor Ricardo Rossello called for more rapid relief efforts, otherwise, there will be a massive exodus to the mainland United States. Mr. Trump has come under fire for focusing on a feud with NFL players and coaches instead of disaster relief in the devastated U.S. territory. The White House on Monday rejected criticism that the Trump administration has been slow to respond in the aftermath of Hurricane Maria. Maria, which struck last Wednesday, left more than a dozen people dead in Puerto Rico, knocking out electricity, water and telephone services. It tore through the island as one of the most powerful storms in nearly 90 years. Officials in Puerto Rico say it could be months before power is fully restored, which could hinder access to clean water, safe food and medical supplies.